Today we're making some silver nitrate, which is a salt of silver metal. Silver nitrate has historically been used as an antiseptic, and it has a few uses in chemistry. I don't have any plans to use it in a synthesis reaction, but I do want to carry out some demonstrations. I want to finally get around to doing the silver mirror experiment, and I also want to mix it with some magnesium to make a water-sensitive explosive. I do already have a video where I demonstrate the mixture of magnesium and silver nitrate, but I really want to revisit it. In general, the process to make silver nitrate is pretty simple. The first thing we do is react silver metal with nitric acid to make a solution of silver nitrate. The water is removed by evaporation, and this leaves behind our silver nitrate. In terms of chemicals, all we need for this preparation is silver metal and some concentrated nitric acid. Both of the silver pieces that you see here weigh about 31.25 grams, which is a little bit above a troy ounce. For the nitric acid, I found a decent amount to use was a little bit more than a milliliter per gram of silver. So to react the 62.5 grams of silver, I used about 65 milliliters of the nitric acid. To start things off, I put the two pieces of silver into a beaker. Onto the silver, I then added about 65 milliliters of concentrated nitric acid. The silver loses its luster almost immediately after adding the nitric acid. As we let the nitric acid sit with the silver, it will take on a yellow color, but not much else will happen. To get the reaction going, we're going to have to heat things up a little bit using a hot plate. It's important not to heat things up too quickly, because we don't want the reaction to be too violent. What we really want to do is add enough heat for the reaction to get going on its own, and once it's started, it will generate its own heat and keep itself going. As we continue to heat things, the color will transition from a yellow to an orange and eventually to a near red. The overall reaction is shown here, where silver is reacting with nitric acid to form silver nitrate, nitrogen dioxide gas, and water. The nitrogen dioxide gas is what gives the solution its color, and the more nitrogen dioxide we produce, the darker the solution is going to get. As the reaction starts to pick up, we'll have a lot of bubbles coming off the silver metal, and we'll start to release some nitrogen dioxide fumes. The fumes will get thicker and thicker, and eventually the reaction will take off. Once the reaction really got going, I turned off the hot plate to prevent it from getting out of control. Nitrogen dioxide gas, in general, is dangerous to breathe, so it's very important to do this in a well-ventilated area. As the silver continues to react, we'll be building up some silver nitrate, and it's important to occasionally stir things. I'm not exactly sure why, but initially, it seems like the silver nitrate has a hard time dissolving. I think we might just be producing silver nitrate faster than it can dissolve into the water, but I'm not exactly sure. When most of the silver is reacted, the reaction will start to die down, and will start to dissolve some of the silver nitrate precipitate we see here. The reaction now is much less vigorous, but we're still just going to have to leave things until most of the silver has dissolved. As we get closer to the end, the solution becomes more colorless, and the color of the nitrogen dioxide gas starts to fade. The most annoying part is when we're very close to the end and we have just some small pieces of silver left that seem to be taking forever to fully react. Because most of the nitric acid has reacted, its concentration of solution is quite low, and the reaction rate is pretty slow. In theory, we could just leave things and let it react, but I was a little bit impatient, so I added some more nitric acid. Not too long after adding the nitric acid, all of the silver is reacted, and now we let things cool down. As we let things cool down, the solubility of silver nitrate in solution will decrease, and eventually, silver nitrate crystals should come out. Sometimes it happens, though, that we get a supersaturated solution, and even when it's cooled down, no crystals come out. To get the solution to crystallize, I'm going to need to provide a seed crystal. There were some crystals that formed on the watch glass, so I knocked these in, and you can see immediately crystals start to form. Once it looks like the crystallization is complete, the solution is placed into a freezer. When the beaker is tilted on the side, you can see all of the nice crystals that have formed. The first thing that I did was dump out any excess liquid. I then placed the beaker on the side, let more liquid pool at the bottom, and then I dumped that out as well. When it seemed like most of the water had been poured off, I used a glass stir rod to break up the crystals. The crystals were then dumped out into a glass bowl. After I dumped out all of the crystals, I looked at the beaker and it seemed like there was still quite a bit left over. To wash out the beaker, I used the water that we had decanted out earlier. Now we have a nice liquidy mixture of silver nitrate and water, and we have to evaporate off the water. My workspace is air conditioned, so the water came off quite quickly. During this drying process, it's pretty important to keep the silver nitrate in the dark because it does degrade when exposed to light. After just a few days, I was left with some super dry silver nitrate crystals. I crushed the crystals into a powder using the bottom of a beaker, and then I transferred them to a container for storage. As I said before, the silver nitrate is sensitive to light, so I covered it with aluminum foil to prevent it from degrading. The final yield of silver nitrate was 96 grams, which corresponds to a percent yield of about 98%. These types of reactions, where we just react a metal with an acid, usually have yields around 100, so this isn't too spectacular. Anyway, now that I have 96 grams of silver nitrate, this is much more than I need. Like I said before, I want to use it to do the silver mirror experiment and to make the water-sensitive explosive with magnesium, but I'm not exactly sure when I'm going to do this. As usual, I'd like to extend a big thanks to all of my supporters on Patreon, and especially those who donate $5 or more. Anyone who donates and supports me on Patreon gets to see my videos 24 hours before I release it to YouTube, and if you donate $5 or more, you get your name at the end of the video like you see here. In the next few months though, I want to work on my Patreon page a lot, and I want to get more rewards going and maybe even get some higher tier ones, and I want to also offer some Patreon exclusive content. Also, as usual, here's the videos that I've currently filmed and the ones I plan to work on. If you have any suggestions or ideas, please feel free to leave them in the comments.